I went to the doctor's last week to get the results of some neurological tests that have been done in hospital over a 2 day period, and hopefully to get a diagnosis for what's causing the neurological symptoms that I've been suffering from the last 15 months or so. And my GP said that the neurologist had diagnosed me as having myalgic encephalitis. And he said that my symptoms were consistent with what would be expected if there was an inflammation in my central nervous system. And while I was there, I asked the GP about managing my symptoms, and I said about the myoclonic jerks that I get. And he said the neurologist has suggested trying clonazepam, which is actually an anti-epilepsy drug, but it works on the central nervous system. Anyhow, I started taking these, and then 2 days later, something unexpected happened. I was still getting some jerks, and I was still having problems with concentration and speaking, but my walking suddenly come back, and for a number of months now I'd really struggled with walking. I would almost shuffle along, and my right toe would drop when I walked and catch on the pavement, and I could only walk very short distances, and with great difficulty and real slowness. A walk that would take me 5 minutes before I was ill would take me 15 minutes, and with a lot of discomfort and disorientation. But suddenly I found that I could walk normally. My legs were working completely normally. My foot no longer dropped. I could walk at normal speed, and I was as if I was starting to get well again. And I was a little bit cautious about how much to push myself. I'd had a very short spell for about 2.5 days in December when a similar thing happened to me, and I got as far as going to the doctors to see about going back to work, and came back and went crashing back down again. So I was a bit more cautious this time, and I didn't push myself too hard. But on the fourth day, I managed to walk in all a good 2 miles, perhaps even three, over the course of that day, all at normal speed and all without any real complications at all. And then on the fifth day, yesterday, I went out for a walk, and it was as if someone had turned a switch off. My feet stopped working properly. My foot drop came back. My legs wouldn't move normally. They were slow and difficult to move, and not moving in the way that they should. And it's just one of those disappointments that people with ME suffer. It is such an unpredictable illness. I thought that it might have been the drugs that were helping. I suspected I could have had a remission, but it does seem that I just had a mini remission. And people with ME have these problems with symptoms. They can come and they can go, and it is extremely disappointing when something like this happens. But I had another thing happen yesterday which was also quite disappointing, in that I got a letter from my employer saying that they can no longer wait for me to get well, and that they were going to terminate my employment due to ill health and my inability to perform my duties. Now, I was expecting it, and I had been in contact with my union rep and with my employer, and I knew it was coming, but when it was written in black and white, it was extremely difficult to take in. Used to work as a deputy manager in a residential school for children with profound disabilities, mainly cerebral palsy, but many of them had profound learning as well as physical disabilities. And it was a job that I really loved. I came into it quite late in life, and I was going as far as I was doing a degree with the Open University, and I just got my diploma when this illness struck. And I am very fortunate, I have to admit. When I when I start feeling bad about myself, I think of these young people, and I've had so much in life which they will never experience. I have four now grown-up children. I've been married to my wife for nearly 27 years and still very much in love with her, and have very many good things, and these young people will never experience. And I've known a number of young people to die as young as the age of 14. So my disability is nothing, but there is still a huge disappointment in me not being able to go back to work, and it's as if the door's been shut and no other's been opened at the moment. I don't know what my future holds. I don't know whether I will ever be able to go back to that type of work. I don't know whether this illness is going to go after a few years, or whether it's going to be something I'm going to have to deal with for the rest of my life. And this is the thing with ME. There's a bereavement that comes. Old goals and plans have to be put to one side, because there are things that you can no longer do which you used to be able to do. And as I say, I'm that much older. I know that there are young people with ME who had all their plans before them, many wanting to go to university and had their career set out, and suddenly cut short because of this illness. And it's because of this is why we need to, people with ME need to campaign to the government that there is proper research done into this illness, that they stop just putting it together with chronic fatigue and see that ME is a real neurological disease and devastates people's lives. Now, I might sound as if I'm completely despairing, but I'm not. I have an optimistic outlook on life. I have a faith that I am a Christian, and I do believe that no matter what I go through, that God is here with me, and that he does care for me, and I do thank him for the good things that I have. But the illness is never good. Yes, there are good things that you can learn about yourself through illness, but it's never good, and I don't believe it's something that we should just accept. So I just share this with you, and to say that those of us that are suffering these things, that we need to be vocal and not let governments just turn a blind eye to us. We need to make ourselves visible, and for research to be done that looks into the true causes of this condition, which varies in so many different ways, and it is so devastating to people's lives. Thank you for watching this video.